Hey everyone, Nathan Revelajance here from Nintendo Prime. Be sure to drop a like on this video, subscribe for more content, and enter our Nintendo Switch Super Smash Bros. Ultimate Bundle giveaway through the Gleam.io link down in the description. Now, what you are looking at right here is the E3 2019 preliminary show floor plans. It's preliminary because not everything is set in stone yet, but we get a good look at things, and there's a few things I want to highlight, but let's just go into the main halls here, specifically the West Hall, since that's where Nintendo's at. Now, when you go into the West Hall, you'll see Nintendo America has the two spots here. This reserved area here as well is typically also Nintendo of America. This is where basically all the staff members go to hang out. That's also where you can like go and try to get booth tours, and if you have any private interviews or whatever, it usually happens up in this area. Now, some people said that, oh, this looks bigger than last year's, and it's not actually. Here is a map of last year's. Let me bring this up for you guys. And you'll see that Nintendo has basically the same two spots here. So definitely not any bigger for Nintendo. Now, what you'll notice last year, of course, is you have Sony Interactive Entertainment over here. They are not here this year. We'll get into what replaced this massive area that Sony had, which was overall more floor space than Nintendo. And as I said, Nintendo always has that reserved spot over there. Sega is over here. This was last year. Down here, see the Gung Ho right here? This was all Ninjala last year. And then this stuff here was like a bunch of Nintendo video game stuff that some outlets out there were pushing. And yeah, but anyways, I can go into all this in more detail if you want of last year's map. But we're here to focus on this year. So Nintendo of America, Nintendo has actually the exact same amount of booth space. That is what I wanted to note here. All right, so Nintendo has the same amount of space. This reserve spot here is probably Nintendo again, too. What's notable is the Sega area has moved from here to down here. And Sega took over not only the spot that Gung Ho was at last year, but also the two little spots where there were a bunch of Nintendo games and then like these companies selling Nintendo games. So Sega just took up this entire area. It's actually a really big chunk of space. I mean, as you can see, it's roughly half the size of Nintendo's primary booth area. So that is definitely something to keep in mind. And this is usually like Nintendo's entire booth. Over here, again, is more private areas where you could like play games and stuff like this. It'd be interesting to see if the Warp Pipe Pass maybe gets us over here, or if it's just more over here. Anyways, it's the same show floor space. Nintendo basically has the same show floor space every single year. How they lay it out is a little different every single year. So last time Nintendo Treehouse was up here, up on a platform, 2 years ago, up on the platform, up at the top where they had like multiple levels, was actually a press area. So we'll see how they set up the booth this time around. Oculus is in here next to Nintendo in the old Sega space from last year. So that's very interesting. Oculus having a big presence. I scroll over here, you see Satisfy Gaming. They are a gaming accessory maker. One of the primary things they are known for is actually the Satisfy grip for Switch. So maybe we'll head on over to that booth and check out some gaming accessories. This one hasn't been claimed yet. Friend Times, I'm not sure what that is, but that's a booth that's going to be there. Little Buddy, not sure, it could be an indie studio, I'm guessing. Studio A, it doesn't really say anything here, but that's an indie studio, I believe. Geico Gaming, no idea what Geico is doing here, but they apparently are here. The space is still available. IndieCade International Independent Game Showcase, so those will be a bunch of indie titles. They have one of these there almost every single year. The Unreal Garden at E3, I'm not sure what this is. I'm assuming it's a bunch of Unreal Engine stuff, but I don't know, because they did not have this last year. This is all new. The E3 Networking Lounge, again, that is all new. So I'm guessing this is just a hangout place where you can like chill and rest your feet for a little bit. I'm not sure if this is like some place where there's going to be live streaming from or what. The Mar Arcade / Bionic, they are also an accessory maker. They used to have a booth like this one right here, I think was the Bionic one last year. So now they've moved over here across from Nintendo of America. GameSpot has moved over here as well. I think GameSpot was actually in the other hall last year, if I remember right. Lenovo's here. You know, maybe they have some gaming laptops or something to show off. XC Games, we got over here. We got the College Game Competition Gaming Lifestyle Pavilion. They had this last year as well. It was a little smaller than this, but it's basically a showcase of games that some college students put together. It's really cool. This is IGDA. Take this stack up. I'm not sure who that is. You get the E3 Esports Zone with Shaq News also in the mix there with a little spot of it. So Shaq News has a little part of the Esports E3 Esports Zone. Again, this is obviously just a place showing off on competitive games. Big Ben's here. IGN is usually right here where Lenovo is. Lenovo in this spot right here, usually IGN. Notably, I did not see IGN anywhere. Maybe they have this reserve space above Nintendo. This is usually tables and chairs up here for people to kind of sit down and relax. But last year, they removed the tables and chairs and they made it a giant line for Nintendo. So this could be a line area that Nintendo has reserved. Over here, we just have some available areas. We have Performance Design Products. Perfect World Games is here. G Fuel, which is a big sponsor. I might actually get a hold of them, see if they want to throw sponsorship at the channel. Probably not, but that's wishful thinking. And then Opera Solutions. I'm not sure who that is. And then we have AMD has a little section up here. So they usually have some computers and stuff like that. So yeah, that is the West Hall. Used to be considered the primary hall since it used to house Microsoft, Nintendo, and Sony. However, with Nintendo being the only one in here because Microsoft's in their own building, it'll be interesting to see if this actually is considered a primary hall anymore because a lot of the big names are not in here now. The big names you're going to find at E3 won't be platform holders. It will be, you know, companies like Sega. So now the other hall becomes very interesting. So if we go to the South Hall, oh boy, look at all the companies here. So let's compare this to the South Hall of last year. Let me open this up here. So as you can see in the smaller picture, Bethesda is basically in the exact same spot. Ubisoft is in the exact same spot. And what's notable is about a quarter of this area, this upper left quadrant of the Ubisoft area is basically dedicated to Just Dance. It's where they have the giant Just Dance stage, and you can like go up there and dance and stuff like that. That's what it's been for a few years. I don't think it's going to change now as long as they're still making Just Dance. Square Enix is basically in the exact same spot. We have Alienware here. Alienware used to be up here, so they kind of moved down closer to the entrance, which will get them a little bit more attention. AK Racing, Modus Games, Black Shark Technology, VPX Sports, a broadcast center. So there'll be some broadcasting going on, some live streaming. Next Level Racing Simulations, VPX Sports, and then a couple of available spots. Carnox is here. This is interesting. The Joint Force Initiatives, that's new. That wasn't here. Epic Games has moved from over here to a slightly bigger space down here. They used to be occupied by, let's see here, who's it say? Take-Two Interactive and Twitch used to be down there, but now that's being occupied by Epic Games. So that's interesting. 2K is over here. They kind of moved from like half of the spot to over here to a bigger booth. THQ Nordic is here. The THQ Nordic spot used to be a Microsoft Mixer spot. So Warner Bros. Interactive has a slightly bigger area. Actually, I shouldn't say slightly. It's almost twice the size of last year. So they're going to have something obviously to show off. Over here, this is the shopping district. So this was new to E3 last year. This is where you can go and buy a whole bunch of gaming gear and goodies and stuff. So let's just go through like what they got. Ewin Racing there. So buying some of those racing, those like office chairs, kind of like this one, my Maxonomic. They have chairs like that. Mayflash Limited, AIM Controllers, Rainbow Horse, Gentle Giant Studios. So there might be a little game studio in there that decided to get a smaller booth. eGuardian Group, Todak, Chronicle Collectibles. Again, place where you can buy stuff. Tegway, Shenzhen Shades, Beijing Skyline Interaction, Fluid Stance, AI Carrier, Soul Seed. A lot of these places you'll be able to buy stuff from. Game Kit. I think Game Kit's one of the ones that were selling like these giant cube boxes of like random gaming gear. Momo Gaming Convention, Click Entertainment. These are all the ones. And these are, a lot of them might be the same from last year and some new ones. Perfect Game Speed Company. So 5 Hour Energy, woo! Tekken Sprint. All this great stuff. So some of these aren't bought up yet, but again, there's still time for them to fill up. MetaThreads, LF Gaming, Giant Games, Gaming Outfitters, Vipod, it's a whole bunch of stuff. Some tables and chairs and some bathrooms back here. There's not really any food you can buy on the show floor. You kind of have to go outside the show floor to get your food. So so looking over here, you got Facebook Gaming. I believe that's new. Let me look at this. I don't remember Facebook Gaming. Yeah, there was Samsung, but there was no Facebook Gaming. So the esports stuff moved to the other hall. Let's see here. THQ Nordic, ESA Foundation, Red Hydrogen's there. Super Soul Bros. What we got here? Haymaker. I don't know who that is. Red, let's see here. National Video Game Museum. That's interesting. Let's see here. Volt Ed. CSUN is here. Sensorium. Double Fine. Tastemakers. Funko. So there's going to be a Funko Pop area. I bet you can buy some Funko Pop there. Rainer Games. Hyperkin. Hyperkin, another accessory maker. X-Rocker. Ooh, custom controllers. So there might be some custom controllers going on there. So pretty interesting stuff. Again, this is a lot better laid out than the map I have for last year. So my biggest takeaway, I guess, is that this hall has kind of become the bigger hall of the two. If you are attending E3 with a Gamer Pass or industry, this is the hall where you're probably going to spend a majority of your time if you're not there to play just Nintendo games. And it is notable, there will be Nintendo like versions again, like Bethesda. If you want to play things like Doom Eternal or Wolfenstein Youngblood, Bethesda will have it available here to play on Switch, usually without very many lines. Because they'll have these games also like in the Nintendo side, and everyone will wait in line for hours and hours and hours to play those games, and you can just go to the Bethesda booth. And I like looking at these maps because it helps me map out maybe what my plan is. Like, I know Ubisoft will probably have at least one game for Switch. Bethesda will have those two games for sure. Square Enix might have at least one game. 2K might have NBA 2K. Epic Games, you know, Fortnite, but you know, I don't know if they have anything else for Switch, so I don't know. That's kind of like an area you can maybe skip. So Capcom will probably have a game or two. So it kind of gives me an idea of like how I want to hit things as I'm mapping out my journey. Obviously the one that everyone knows all about is the West Hall, where Nintendo of America is seated. And Sega, you know, has a much bigger booth this year, so it's going to be interesting to see what Sega has planned. Probably some games for Switch as well. They had Valkyrie Chronicles 4, Team Sonic Racing last year as well. Although you couldn't play the Switch version on the show floor. Anyway, I think it's just really cool to look at the map. I hope you guys learned a bunch of stuff if you are interested. If there's anything you want to glean out of this, obviously the big change is this used to all be Sony. This whole area here is all Sony plus up here. So a whole bunch of it is now just a bunch of random stuff. It's still going to be really exciting. This obviously is not the layout for Microsoft's area. Microsoft has their own area, and you can't really look at their mapping out of that ahead of time. So you just kind of go into it not knowing what to expect. But that's something that hopefully we get into this year. We didn't get to go in last year, so I can't even describe what last year's experience was like with Microsoft. But I think if we map things out correctly, take advantage of the Warp Pipe Pass, we should be done with Nintendo and all the ones in here day one, I'm hoping. And then we'll hop on over to the rest on day two, and then maybe hit Microsoft on day three. We'll see. Anyways, thank you guys so much for tuning in. I hope you enjoyed this look at the map layout for E3. Man, the E3 hype is real, is it not? I'm getting more and more excited. I mean, again, I'm just every single day is one day closer to Eric and I heading out to E3 to get ready to cover that event for you guys. I hope you're looking forward to our E3 coverage, which will start officially, I believe, either on June 5th or June 6th. June 6th for sure. I haven't decided if I'm going to do my first E3 vlog on June 5th, since we're just going, you know, we're just driving an hour and a half to a hotel. It's not really too exciting, but we'll probably start the journey that next morning on the 6th. So thank you guys for tuning in. I love your faces, and I'll see you in the next video.